we have a verse, chorus, verse, chorus, and then I want Joe to take a solo after the second chorus, and we can talk about if you want to just stick with like the chord progression of the song, the existing song, or change it up. And then I kind of have some ideas for maybe like a cool instrumental breakdown after that. I have some ideas for like riff we can all double and see how it sounds, but I kind of want to experiment from there.
That's one of the things I love about the acoustic blues guys, is there's a rawness and an imperfection that lets the listener in and gives you so much stank. And so I wrote that riff on The Wise and Born, and I was like, God, I gotta write a song to this riff, and I have to have Joe Bonamassa play on it. I became friends with Joe Bonamassa. I have no idea how he knows who I am. I'm such a big fan. I'd actually had the title Don't Talk to Me Like I'm Tiffany. I just love the alliteration of it, that Don't Talk to Me Like I'm Tiffany, for a while. I'm about done feeling smart now, watching this scene. Tip my hat and thank you for your time. I gotta give it to you all. You got some big balls for a boy with a small mind. I had a few encounters in my life where like I witnessed some disrespect happening. I'm a very sensitive person, and Tiffany is just a song about witnessing disrespect or injustice and just how that makes you feel so kind of gross inside. And you just have kind of some anger and rage, and you just feel like this is bullshit, you know? That song is about not wanting that for yourself, not wanting that for anyone else, but understanding that you can't control anyone else. You can only control yourself. And in the end, if other people choose to disrespect or choose to put up with disrespect, that is unfortunately their prerogative, and all you can do is tell your truth. Good man trying to cover their tracks, but we ain't gonna waste them
on you. And then Joe Bonamassa is gonna play like the most like.
Can you do that, please?
The most like swampy, like lo-fi, like down in the dumps, like gritty, gross solo ever.
You know, did you read my bio before you came over?
No, I didn't. So he does his first solo, does the second solo, did a couple run-throughs, and he comes up and listens to the first solo, and he looks at us and said, don't lose that. I don't think I could ever do that again.
It was $8,000. I got a deal on it, and I paid $215,000 for it. You want to play it?
Oh my God! Let me drink my water first. I'm like shaking. That is so awesome.
Have you ever dropped a guitar
in your life? Oh yeah, yeah.
Okay, well don't drop it. Exactly.
Today's not that day.
Yeah, today's not the right
day. Terry Reed was he was a very very he still is he's still around. He's an awesome songwriter, singer. He bought this in 68 when he was open for Cream. And Dan Armstrong put this in New York when they got the Madison Square Garden. Oh, wow. And I know this is Terry Reed's guitar because I bought it from him. That's a 55.
I'm Strat
girl. 54s, 55s are different animals. Like, again, it's like second year production. It doesn't have a huge V-neck. Most of the time you see really V'd stuff in 56, late 56. Mm-hmm. Crazy.
Yeah. 56. What do you think, Jason?
I said it's butter.
Yeah, it's butter.
Yeah. Yeah. It is, yeah.
That is an 84 overdrive special. And I have four of them.
Do you?
Mm-hmm. Wow. Stupid boy. That, by the way, is my favorite Fender amp Lee ever made.
Really?
That is what do you love about it? 210 Vibraverb.
Why do you love it so much?
It just does everything. It's really the Ginsu knife. It does everything. Not a Vibrolux, though. Completely different amp. But those, it was the first Fender amp they made. They made them for 1 year. They made about 600 of them. And it's the first Fender amp they produce with onboard reverb. Before that, you'd have to buy the tank.
Which is also so awesome.
Great. Different animal. Because yeah. They basically would, they, you know, because the tanks have tone and dwell. So they made it a fixed setting.
Like a, going back to the major.
That's more in character than the rest of the song to me.
I think so too, because if we can make it big. Yeah.
Ultimately, I probably won't be doing this on acoustic. It'd probably be an electric part.
Uh-huh.
Right? What do you guys think?
Yeah.
So if you were doubling it on acoustic, and then... Just because she pats you on the back. Just because she pats you on the back. Doesn't mean that you have a spine. Was that a good one? Can I hear it? Just because she pats you on the back. Doesn't mean that you have a spine. But I'm about done standing by, not letting this fly. Tip my hat and thank you for your time. I gotta give it to you. You got some big balls for a boy with a small eye.